on south to Tobacco Road, and you'll find Chapel Hill, where North Carolina seniors are winning and making them the fifth-ranked team in the nation. Further down the road are the Duke Blue Devils at number 12 and just behind North Carolina in the ACC. The Blue Devils and Carolina up next. Hello once again, everyone, and welcome to ESPN's NCAA basketball. The second game of the day, we move to the ACC. Duke will face North Carolina. Tar Heels 13-1. They've won 11 consecutive games. They're 2-0 in the conference. Duke 14-3. They have won four games in a row. They are 3-1 in the conference. We will have another game following this one after we step aside for sports, and we'll come back at midnight Eastern time, BYU and Wyoming. That one at midnight straight up. Let's get a couple of other scores from the ACC. Virginia and Georgia Tech. Tech simply rolls here, 78-51. Kenny Anderson, 21 points in the game. North Carolina State loses at Wake Forest, 97-76. Rodney Rogers, 23 points and 15 rebounds. And Temple all over Clemson in a non-conference game. Mark Macon, what a day, 36 points, 8 three-pointers in the game. The Owls at one point went on a 30-7 run in the second half. So stay with us at halftime. We will have scores and highlights of these and other games. Plus, if anything happens in the Persian Gulf and the crisis there, we will update Desert Storm. So stay with us. Next, we'll go to the ACC, the North Carolina Tar Heels, taking on the Blue Devils of Duke. That one's coming your way in just a moment.
One big reason why you should be in church next week. Your children. Whatever their age is, there's so much they can learn in church about life and love and positive values, about families and faith and hope that only God can give. So bring your children to church. You might learn something too.
Duke Chapel, on the campus of Duke University, Durham, North Carolina. All is quiet here as the shadows lengthen, while half a world away, there is anything but quiet and serenity, as war in the Gulf continues to be of great concern to everyone. And although we are all troubled, we ask you to allow ESPN the opportunity to provide a brief respite from the tension, and join us on campus at Duke University, a school that provides the kind of environment that can make college basketball what it's meant to be. It's the same campus where 49 years ago, Duke and Durham, North Carolina, played host to the Rose Bowl when World War II forced that game away from Pasadena on the West Coast. Join us in a storied arena where the memories from so many great games still linger. That's why they are here, the more than 1,600 residents of Krzyzewskiville. They've been here for 14 days in those tents, all for a chance to watch a great rivalry. There is no question, even as great a rivalry as this has been, that events here pale in comparison to events in the Middle East. But let us respectfully invite you, for the next couple of hours at least, to enjoy one of college basketball's premier rivalries, North Carolina versus Duke. So welcome to Cameron Indoor Stadium, and as you watch, we hope that you will remember why we should cherish the privilege of being an American.
Los Angeles again.
Carlson?
He's from Apple Computer's ad agency. They want to do a commercial about us.
Would we get to be in the commercial?
No. Because we can't do it.
Why not?
Over the past 15 months, we've doubled our productivity. We've cut development time by a third.
That's what I mean.
Why would we go on national TV and tell our competition exactly how we did it?
ESPN's presentation of NCAA basketball, North Carolina versus Duke.
is brought to you by Honda, maker of fine quality automobiles. Test drive a Honda at your local dealer today. And by HBO, simply the best.
Cameron Indoor Stadium in Durham with its usual packed house of 9,314 to see one of the great rivalries in the game, the Tar Heels and the Blue Devils. First, the starting lineup for North Carolina. King Rice has had some of his best games against Duke and has done particularly well in matchups with Bobby Hurley. Dean Smith now with 701 victories. If he would want to coach another 7 years, he could catch the legendary Adolph Rupp for number one all time. For Duke, Christian Laettner is having a brilliant season, 20 points, 10 rebounds a game. He has already had 11 double-doubles. And Mike Krzyzewski, the winningest coach in Duke history in just his 11th year in Durham, he has taken his team to the Final Four four of the last 5 years.
Mike, when you talk about a guy that has an interest in a Middle East crisis, Peter Chilcutt's brother, Michael, is stationed in the Middle East, in the Persian Gulf. He's in the U.S. Marine Corps. And Peter's been really, really hot lately. He's dedicated the season to his brother, Michael. I know Michael can be proud of Peter, but Peter's certainly proud of Michael, fighting to protect our honor and our hearts, and our sentiments go out. And I thought you did a great job, Mike, to open up the show.
Thank you, Dick. Chilcutt, jumping center with Laettner. Duke basketball, Lang gives it off to Bobby Hurley. Hurley says he has gotten down in the past when things have gone poorly, but he rededicated himself earlier this season to be more consistent. Laettner with a miss. Loose ball. McCaffrey has it.
That was right after the Virginia game when he really struggled in that blowout against Virginia. He said he's regrouped and he's ready to play as a mature, experienced player. He's been shooting it.
McCaffrey won't go. Almost knocked away by Laettner, but rebounded by Chilcutt. Here comes King Rice. Played well against Hurley, and they go inside immediately to Montross, the 7-foot freshman, and he's fouled.
Montross along that baseline with the good catch. King Rice with the good entry. You know, Rice has really played brilliantly, as you mentioned earlier, against Duke. You look at his numbers last year in the two wins, 79-60. Rice had a big game, and in the 87-75 win, he also had a big game. He scored 20 points.
Foul was on Antonio Lang, his first. Montross has struggled at the free throw line, under 50%. Looked pretty good on that stroke.
Yeah, had a nice stroke right there. It's been documented. Montross, the big guy in that recruiting class, rated as the premier recruiting class in America last year.
Hit the second one, 2-0 Carolina. Carolina, the only undefeated team left in the ACC. They are 2-0. Duke 3-1 with an early season loss to Virginia. McCaffrey with Henrik Rodal on him. This is Davis.
Davis
teamed in that trap, almost a steal.
Davis has really scored well since Hill went out with a broken nose. Man-to-man defense. North Carolina really has improved defensively, Mike. They're allowing the opposition 41% field goal percentage this year versus last year, about 49.
McCaffrey sort of a double clutch and missed the shot. Outlet pass gets by King Rice and turned over to Duke.
King Rice has to be one of the most maligned players in college basketball for a guy that has produced. Another player I put in that category, LaRon Ellis up at Syracuse.
Rice has been able to talk Hurley into a couple of bad games since he has been at Duke.
They really
he went to him and said, look, it's nothing personal. It's just the way I play. And Hurley said he understood. Lang off balance, forced it. Laettner got it.
That was a tough offensive rebound by Christian Laettner. He's having a big, big year this year.
The 19th all-time scorer in Duke history. He has 11 double-doubles this year. He'll easily pass Danny Ferry, who didn't do that well when he was the 89 player of the year.
The other thing that makes Laettner so special is his versatility. He's an excellent passer from out on the perimeter.
Foul was on McCaffrey, his first, the team's second.
Duke has been a different team since McCaffrey got back in the lineup after an ankle injury against Michigan. The last four games, he and Hurley have played exceptionally well.
Fox outside with Davis on him. Rodal alone for the three, passed on it. And got the roll. Nice drive by Henrik Rodal.
Rodal recognizes the seam in the defense. Good move to the basket.
Laettner caught in the lane, forced the pass to Davis. He forced his shot and got it.
Little lucky right there with Brian Davis.
Davis had five straight double-figure games, as Dick mentioned, coming in off the bench. Here's the strip and the steal. Davis behind the back dribble to get free and ran right over King Rice.
That's got to be an offensive foul.
King Rice got position.
King Rice in excellent defensive position. Both feet planted on the ground.
And quickly, that is the third team foul against the Blue Devils. Gilbert Davis, number 40, will check in for Carolina.
In that matchup last year between Rice and Hurley, Hurley was 2-for-9 in the first game with 10 turnovers. And Rice had the big game, 13 points and 9 assists.
Chilcutt, nice turnaround jumper. Did not get the roll. Good rebound to Davis. Outlet to Hurley. Here comes Rice back the other way. Boy, remember the great defensive job that Hurley did on Kenny Anderson?
He really did. He got over the top of the screen. There's a walk-in violation. Hurley played excellent defense against Kenny Anderson. But Anderson today was brilliant against Virginia in that blowout because he distributed the ball, didn't try to force his shots as he did against Hurley when he had probably one of the worst 25-point games he could ever have.
Three turnovers for Carolina. Duke with a chance to take the lead. Davis had it knocked out of bounds by Fox.
King Rice says he loves this environment. He loves coming in here, playing against Duke. And I can understand why. He's had such big games against him. Remember 2 years ago when he was inserted in a lineup because Jeff Lebo was out for an injury? And they beat Duke 91-71, and he had a big game.
Well, he's not known for shooting. There's the inbound to McCaffrey. He's trapped in the lane. Nobody goes up with him, so he takes the shot and misses. Against Virginia, Rice hit a basket to put it into overtime and then hit the game winner. Fox, who can drill the three, air ball that time. And it's knocked out of bounds out to Duke, and he'll hear about it from the Duke crowd.
Well, they're going to let him definitely hear about a little air ball chant.
Fox has struggled with his shot a little bit this year.
He had a bad game against Maryland shooting the ball, but then bounced back real strong against Virginia.
Mike Krzyzewski has four substitutes coming to midcourt waiting to come in. Great drive by McCaffrey.
Excellent drive by McCaffrey, but no one rotates over to close off the driving angle.
Hubert Davis back the other way, had it knocked out of his hands, maintained control.
Laettner and Chilcutt, interesting matchup inside.
Rice with the drive, missed the shot. And follow shot is good by Hubert Davis. We're tied at 6 with 15:37 to go first half. Both teams a little tight right now. Hurley wide open for three. Those are the ones that have to go down. Fox with a rebound. Hurley's been shooting 38% from three-point range, but didn't have a good stroke on that last one. Hubert Davis. And Rice will reload. Isolated him on the side with Hurley. Can't do anything with him. Hubert Davis got caught up in the air. The crowd wanted a travel. They'll get a foul instead. It's called on Antonio Lang, his second. Montross comes back in. Chilcutt will get a breather for Carolina.
Hubert Davis certainly gives them a scorer when he comes in that lineup. He has great scoring potential, Mike.
That's four team fouls against Duke. Carolina has yet to commit one. Tied at six, 14:57 to go. Crowd does not distract Davis, who is an 81% shooter from the line. He has 3 points. Here comes Kenny Harris into the game, and King Rice will get a breather. They were really hurt when Kenny Harris had the bad knee and missed a few games. Rice had to play more minutes than Dean Smith would have liked.
Well, they lost Derek Phelps. I think that's who you're
referring to. Yeah, I'm sorry, Derek Phelps.
Phelps is the guy that they're really counting on, the tremendous freshman from out of New York City.
should see him. Free throw is good. Carolina takes an 8-6 lead over Duke. 14:57 to go, first half.
I think it's absolutely necessary that we approach this with a lot of dignity. And I'm saying that in regards to especially Peter Chilcutt from North Carolina's team, whose brother is serving in the Middle East. I think it's a time to keep perspective, to keep dignity, and to beat Carolina.
And that's one of the benefits of living in Krzyzewskiville for a couple of weeks. You get a film breakdown and a chat with the coach on Thursday night. And they call everybody in out of the cold and out of the tents and talk to them about the game. It's 8-6 Carolina, 14:57 to go, first half. And full court pressure from North Carolina out of the timeout. They get it into Grant Hill, who was playing with that face mask, suffered a broken nose, missed two games, most of a third, but has come back strong from that. Hurley being guarded by Harris. Hill can't get inside, Lynch is on him, then turns around, takes the jumper, tipped, and Rodel will come out with it. Turnover there, and Duke will have a chance again to get the lead. Trying to wear down Hurley, first King Rice, then Harris, and here comes the trap with Fox.
They got to reverse the ball, look for the diagonal pass.
And a reach-in foul called on Kenny Harris.
Kenny Harris getting some play-in time as a backup.
Tar Heel foul on number four, Kenny Harris, his first, his team's first.
It's only the first team foul called on North Carolina in nearly 6 minutes of play. Trying inbound, they finally get it in. Hill backing in on Lynch. Turnaround jumper.
Mike, he's an excellent baseline player. Very smooth.
Lynch down low, had it blocked from behind by Laettner. Jump ball.
Christian Laettner with that good rotation over on George Lynch, who's a tremendous jumper. The entry down to Lynch. Lynch has got the good jumping ability, but there's Laettner rotating from the behind. Three people. That was actually Kubek. It wasn't Laettner. It was Kubek coming from behind. Man-to-man defense, as usual, by Duke.
Rozier is number 45, another sensational freshman.
Mike Krzyzewski thinks he can be the best of all of the freshmen.
Lynch lost it on the way up, and it's out to Carolina.
The last 4 minutes have been a nightmare for me, Mike. It's very difficult to call a game when you don't hear your partner.
Good penetration. Rodel drops it to Lynch. Got it, and Carolina goes back up by two.
If George Lynch improves his perimeter play on that wing, he's going to be an outstanding player. Everybody knows what he can do down in the boxes inside.
Rice is back in and on Hurley. Kubek wide open. Kubek has just never found his shooting rhythm in his entire career at Duke. Came in with a reputation as a great outside shooter. Montross, the seven-footer with a miss. Out of bounds to Duke.
Montross didn't really have a good angle at the basket.
Hubert Davis is back in and Rodel is out as Dean Smith continues to shuffle his players. Dick, do you think he's got the kind of rotation he wants with his players now?
I really believe they're getting close to it. If you look at the minutes in the second half, he really gets into his top eight players.
Hurley finds Thomas Hill open. His shot won't go and Duke has gone real cold. Davis, oh, what a burst of speed, and what a block by Kubek. Holy cow, what a play. Here's Hill back the other way. And now they're saying the ball was touched on the rim as the trailer, Thomas Hill, got it in the circle, no basket.
That was an excellent call by Lenny Wurz. He definitely interfered. Kubek makes the good defensive play. That's the second good defensive play he has made. They push it up in transition, and he definitely interfered with the ball up on the cylinder.
And it was an offensive foul called on Grant Hill.
After he gave the ball up, he went into a charge.
Have a good officiating crew tonight. Lenny Wurz, Larry Rose, and Duke Edsel.
Poor shot right there by Rozier.
Rozier really forced that one.
Duke's got to swing the ball a little bit more side to side, get a little bit more emotional offensively.
Hurley, tough pass for Laettner. It's a good catch, and he's fouled in the lane. And they point at Rozier. That will be his first.
Laettner has excellent hands. There's the look by Hurley. He says, come on, Christian, make this catch. Come on, make this catch. Give me an assist. There's the hands. He keeps the ball alive.
This is meant as the highest kind of compliment, but every time that I see him play, he reminds me more of Danny Ferry.
Well, Danny Ferry is one of those special players ever to play in college basketball.
Hill with a turnaround jumper, the sophomore out of Lancaster, Texas.
Nice post move by Hill to catch the ball in that deep and turn and shoot that little spinning jumper on a baseline.
Hurley waiting on Rice.
Carolina goes into a 1-4 set.
Davis, offensive rebound, foul underneath. It will be on Rozier, pushing off his second.
Cliff Rozier trying to establish good offensive rebound and position. What a career he had in Bradenton, Florida, Southeast High School. Rated as the best power forward coming out of the high school ranks last year.
11:41 to go in the first half from Cameron Indoor Stadium. We're tied at 10. Our game has been tied at 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. We have 11:41 to go. First half from Durham, North Carolina. Full court press by Carolina. Kenny Harris on McCaffrey, who gives it up to Hurley.
I like that skip pass that you throw right over the top of the defense, especially against good pressure defense, because they help so much.
Grant Hill had it stuffed in the lane. And a reach in foul, no, a travel.
Not a good play by Kenny Harris. He tried to create a play that wasn't there. One against three, should have brought the ball back out so they could have set up offensively.
Full court pressure again.
See, Hill gives him another ball handler, Mike. He's such a smooth ball handler. It's like having three guards on the floor.
Duke with a chance to take the lead.
North Carolina really has improved its defense.
Grant Hill kicks it back out. Now Hurley.
Spacing. They got to have better spacing offensively, Duke.
Boy, very aggressive Carolina defense.
They're really taking pride in their defense this year.
Thomas Hill. Won't go.
He's been told King Rice at the end of the year as there's a foul on that end.
They'll call a foul on Matt Wenstrom.
Wenstrom, a 7-footer, part of their blue team, gets a couple of minutes here and there, but an excellent practice player. As you look at Michelangelo, Bill Ford standing behind him, 701 W's, the most of any active coach, and has an outside shot to catch the Baron, Adolph Rupp's 875.
Last time I talked to him, he said, no way, I'm not going to coach that long.
He said, no way, when he was at 600 trying to get to 700. And you know, but he told King Rice at the end of last year that we are going to improve defensively. That's going to be our goal, and they have really done it.
Trapped in the corner, a bad pass.
He's got a trailer. He's got the trailer. Oh, what a tough deuce that was.
Reese hanging on the jump shot and scored, and Carolina back by two.
Tough basket by the Frosh. Brian Reese, great athletic ability.
And McCaffrey got caught in a double team, bounced it out of bounds.
Right now, Duke's not getting what we like to talk about in an offensive scheme. Good spacing to eliminate the double team, spread the offense out, take away the opportunities of trying to pressure.
Reese into the lane, travel.
Out of control.
And Dean Smith goes back to his bench. Fox, Rice, Chilcutt, Lynch, and Davis come back in. Those are the five guys he wants on the court most of the time. Carolina has turned it over seven times tonight, Duke four. At one point, it was 4-0.
North Carolina's been turning the ball over most of the year. When you look at their turnover ratio, I relate it basically to not having a true rhythm when you're constantly substituting.
Although King Rice, the point guard, the man most often responsible for assists and turnovers, has better than a 2-1 ratio.
He's been brilliant since the Connecticut game. He has played excellent basketball.
Brian Davis forced that one, and here comes Rice. Been a lot of forced shots, and a great deal of that goes to the aggressive defense by both clubs.
Both teams playing with a lot of intensity. All of the game we had on Monday night, Indiana and Purdue.
Chilcutt, and we're tied at 12.
Chilcutt with that excellent touch. He's been on fire in the last eight games. He's 48-74. He had the big game against Virginia, scored 25 in their win over Virginia, at Virginia.
Hurley's had a tough time getting loose tonight.
See, now they spread the court a little bit better.
Hurley tossed it by Lang.
That's been the problem of Bob Hurley throughout his first 2 years, the turnover ratio. However, his assist ratio and what he creates is really unbelievable because he's not afraid to take a chance. See, the offensive player just a little bit slow coming over to get that good angle for that entry.
Crawford Palmer, number 34, checks into the Duke lineup, and Laettner will get a breather. Palmer, 6'9", a junior out of Arlington, Virginia. Rice looking for Lynch and found him. What a move by Lynch.
George Lynch with a slashing cut without the basketball. Great movement, uses the left hand, kisses it on the glass.
I think Lynch is the best athlete out there. He has 4 points. Boy, Rice done a whale of a job on Hurley so far. There's another bad pass, and that one's knocked out of bounds.
Bobby's trying to create situations that aren't available on the floor, and that's what creates the turnover. I'll tell you, he can wear a uniform for me, though, Mike. There's something special about him. The kid is a winner.
You wouldn't go wrong picking any guard in this league to play for you.
Well, you look at the point guard position in the ACC, I firmly believe that's the greatest group of point guards ever assembled in one conference.
I never saw anything like it. Hurley turns it over there. Fox with a 2-on-1, and then Hurley with the big defense knocks it out of bounds.
Well, he got a lot of help right there from Rick Fox. Not a good decision by Fox in the 2-on-1. Should have taken the ball at Hurley a little bit more and then dropped the bounce pass.
Grant Hill checks back in. Hurley will come out to talk to Mike Krzyzewski. That's Hill with the face mask. They tried just about everything. They had goggles sent from the Lakers. They tried a hockey mask from the Duke Hockey Club at the suggestion of the Baltimore Orioles, of all people.
Well, his dad, Calvin Hill, works for the Baltimore Orioles, and everybody remembers his dad was one heck of a football player for the Dallas Cowboys.
Yeah, the mask he had had a helmet attached to it.
That's for all those wacky guys.
Carolina's ball and a 6-point lead. Alley-oop, and Chilcutt jams it through. Nice pass from Rice.
That was a design play, and a rear screen created the opportunity for Chilcutt. And a great look by King Rice. The rear screen, the toughest screen to defend.
Chilcutt, who averages nearly 13 a game, has 4. Davis off balance, gets it to Grant Hill. His shot won't fall. Duke is just ice cold, and they're down 18-10.
It's got to be a great difficulty for Grant Hill to get a good look at the basket with that mask on.
Fox. Got it. Tough shot, Rick Fox. And Dick, it strikes me that Carolina doing more one-on-one stuff tonight than I can remember.
Well, you know, Rick Fox created the little one-on-one opportunity to the baseline, but he's made a lot of clutch baskets all year long.
Carolina has scored the last 10. Block inside by Chilcutt, but the follow is good, and good hustle inside. Antonio Lang didn't give up.
Lang's got great legs. He's been starting since the broken nose. Grant Hill, good jumper.
Fox for three. Grant Hill with a rebound.
Shot the ball a little bit too quick right there, rather than making it situation where they move the ball 3 or 4 times. See, here's the versatility of Hill playing out on the point.
At 6'7", he can play anywhere. Really forced that shot. Oh, we've said that so many times tonight.
I think the defense is creating the forced shot by forcing the players to go to angles that they don't want on the floor.
Hill defensively at 6'7", now on King Rice, the point guard.
North Carolina in their passing game, like the spread, get 15 feet apart. Pass and go away. Oh, good baseline drive.
Offensive foul. Let's see if the basket counts.
Tremendous defensive play by Palmer rotating over to take that charge.
No basket. 6:28 to go in the first half. North Carolina with a 10-point burst has a 20-12 lead. 6:28 to go in the first half. North Carolina leading Duke 20-12 after a 10-point run. And that's where we're located, up here in the crow's nest. They're not going to have space for broadcasters downstairs and take away from the student seats. And you know what? Any place else I'd complain, but here it's so great you don't want to.
Mike, I'll tell you what. You talk about college environments. This is, to me, the best environment all of college basketball. It's because of the whole scene with the students right on the floor. It's not a very big arena. Everybody can feel the electricity, the emotion. So I say to the Cameron Crazies, this is the America's number one basketball environment.
Duke shooting only 27% so far. That'll help as Greg Kubek hits the jumper, 20-14.
Greg Kubek's had some moments in his career, but as you said earlier, Mike, he came out with a great reputation as a pure shooter. Expectations, that's been a problem with this guy with The Rock, King Rice. Everybody expected the next Phil Ford.
And even when Kubek misses, he looks good doing it. He's got a great looking shot. Lang gets it off to Palmer. Lang got it back, had it blocked inside. Chilcutt with the defensive play. Here comes Rice. Hubert Davis for three. Fox, offensive rebound. Offensive foul, no basket. There can't be two teams in the country that play each other all the time. They're any better than taking charges than these guys.
They really know how to step in and take the charge, Mike. I'm not convinced he got the charge right there. There's the offensive rebound by Rick Feist. I'll take that back.
Yeah.
He definitely did get the offensive charge.
He got his money's worth. That is the sixth team foul against North Carolina. Duke has committed five, and Dean Smith once again, wholesale substitution. And the newest face you'll see is number 14, Derek Phelps, who's in for the first time. That's Montross, who's back in.
Phelps was highly acclaimed as a defensive player. Great quickness.
Boy, this is the third guy that's been on Hurley. They're trying to wear him down.
He can take it, though. He's the kind of kid that's got great endurance.
Kubek missed that one badly. Foul inside. Crawford Palmer pushing off. More college basketball coming your way at midnight Eastern. Brigham Young against Wyoming, Wayne Hagen, and Terry Holland.
I'll tell you a guy you want to see in that game, Sean Bradley. He's going to rewrite all the record books in shot blocks, the 7'5 or 7'4, whatever he is. He's so big, it's incredible down there at BYU.
It's nice to have Terry Holland as part of our crew. We enjoyed him so much for years as the head coach at Virginia, now the athletic director at Davidson. Rozier can't get the baseline. Hubert Davis for three. Montross had the rebound, and he is fouled by Christian Laettner. Or is it the other way around?
Montross pushed off to get inside offensive positioning. He's got to be a little quicker to the basketball. I really believe that Eric Montross has got to work a lot on jump and rope to get a little bit more agility to his game and be a little quicker to the basketball.
Thomas Hill comes back in for Duke, and Rodel is back in for North Carolina.
This game has really had some solid defense because of the help defensively, the effort defensively, and the energy that they're expending. It has not been a smooth game offensively.
Laettner is shooting 82% from the free throw line, but that only makes him number three on this team. We got some guys with great eyes, and he missed that one.
Special situations are so important in a game of basketball. The ability to execute from the free throw line, just like a team in football executing their kicking game.
Rozier. That ill-advised pass, and Laettner with the interception. Laettner back the other way. Tried to avoid the charge and missed the shot. And he ran into Antonio Lang, who is down and hurt for Duke. Rodel gives it up to Montross, had to double clutch it. And now they will stop the action because Lang is laying on the baseline. Now, the reason they didn't stop it before is that Lang, by laying on the ground, was in no danger. There was nobody around him. Once Duke started coming that way, the official stopped the game.
Which was a good decision by the official.
Now, he was involved in the on the drive by Laettner. And when there was contact underneath, he flew back from the pack. Watch the elbow, left hand side. Oh.
Yeah, he caught an elbow right in the face.
From Laettner.
His teammate. Laettner made an excellent play there to make the steal and fill the lane and almost had the conversion in transition to show again his multi-talents. The big guy makes the steal on one end of the floor and almost gets the conversion on the other end.
And it was great body control to pull up because just as he turned, he saw if he really drove to the bucket, he would commit the offensive foul. Instead, he pulled up and tried to finger roll it in.
This guy's more than a basketball player. Antonio Lang was valedictorian of his class, had a 4.0 average. Pretty tough in a classroom as well as on a basketball court. Come out of Mobile, Alabama. Said no. Came very close to going to LSU or Georgetown.
They'll take him to the locker room and attend to him, and you can see that there was some blood from the eye. Hopefully just got caught across the eyebrow. That's the easiest place to get a cut. Gets a nice hand from the Duke students as they have closed the gap to six. 4:25 to go, first half. Duke still only shooting 27% from the floor. Carolina at 40. Laettner, power move inside.
27% and you're only down four. You're in pretty good shape on your home floor.
20-16, 4:09 to go in the half.
With two-man basketball, Hurley and Laettner.
Rodel, Rozier, Forster, a double team, offensive foul, Rozier, that's his third.
Rozier can't get a break. Dean Smith says, what happened? Cliff Rozier going through those freshman struggles right now. Here he is, takes the ball to the goal. He steps right into the offensive, defensive player, leans right in and makes contact.
And Duke really helped the officials make the call. Two guys went down.
He says, no, 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 the Bradenton beauty, Cliff Rozier.
That is three on Rozier. We have 4 minutes to go in the half, and it's a four-point game.
A battle going on tonight in the Big East, number 16 against number 10, and Pitt is down to St. John's in the first half, 28-24. We'll have highlights of these and other games at halftime. Right now, let's go back to Mike and Dick.
All right, thank you very much, John Saunders. 4 minutes to go, 20-16. Carolina leading Duke.
John, Mr. Versatility, working in that studio.
He's everywhere.
I'll tell you, he can do the job, big-time style.
Laettner back to help against full-court pressure. Here comes Bobby Hurley. Rice back on him, the third defender they've had on Hurley, and they've kept him contained. Hurley that time tries the no-look pass. Laettner fighting for it, can't get it. Here comes Rice the other way. Three on two. Fox. Crawford Palmer to Laettner.
Oh, that's the easiest one he'll ever get. And the Wackos go bananas. The Cameron Crazies. Jam City by Laettner. Look at this Wacko, 1,400 on the SATs.
Duke has scored the last eight. Fox stops the run.
Carolina runs the backcourt as well as anybody in basketball out of their passing game. Rich Fox is rated right now by many of the NBA scouts the third best senior small forward behind Stacey Augmon and Chris Gatling from out of Old Dominion.
Hill, tough shot at the baseline, and he got it.
He's got that quick move to the baseline, and he's an excellent shooter. Very streaky, but he has a good touch.
Thomas Hill with four. Rice back the other way. Tough turnaround. Jumper by Chilcutt.
Chilcutt in his fifth year keeps getting better and better.
Well, the offense is picking up a little bit.
Better execution offensively. Better decisions with the ball. 1-2-2 set. Interchange along the wings, looking for the dump down, screen across the lane.
Kubek with a penetration and a hanger, missed it. Here comes Fox. Rice got the deflection, dumps it back, Lynch lost it. Thomas Hill with a nice grab, and then Lynch dives. dives on him, and they'll call Lynch for the foul. And Hill ended up right on the basketball.
Looked like a first and 10 seed right there. George Lynch, you gotta like this guy. Comes to play every night, has the great legs inside. Here's the good looking Rick Fox.
Lynch is 6'7", 214, and believe me, he doesn't back away from anybody, neither does Bobby Hurley.
Bob Hurley said in today's paper that I picked him on my all-whiner team, that he whines. I said, you know, that's a compliment. There are a lot of great players that were whiners. The best of all time is a whiner. I mean, he cried like crazy. A guy by the name of Rick Barry.
Oh, and I was way ahead of you.
Yeah, he could play. I'll tell you one thing, Mike.
Hill will go to the line, 75% free throw shooter. 4 points tonight. It's a bonus situation. That was the 19th foul. Duke as a team is shooting 72.7% from the line. They are always good. So is Carolina, but they're down a little bit this year.
They get the two shots on the 10. Right now they're in a one-on-one scene. But you know, you talk about criers. What about Bill Laettner? Nobody cries more than Laettner right now. That certainly doesn't mean you can't play. I think a lot of times it's frustration city. Billy McCaffrey on the floor. They need his jump shot.
Hill goes out after hitting the free throws and pulling Duke to within two.
The Duke backcourt reminds me of an all-boy scouts backcourt when you talk about McCaffrey and Hurley. Defense, defense, defense,
defense, defense. Lynch kicked it. Rice trying to save it. He's double-teamed. Jump ball.
Created again by no spacing. Whenever you're 4 feet, 5 feet apart, you're in a double-team situation.
And Rice came over and gave Hurley a little grief after that. Big article in the paper today that Rice had given Hurley trouble before.
They like to run their mouth a little bit. That's the competitiveness in them, both guys. Oh, look at him battle. Look at him battle. He said, get out of my way. Get out of my way. Well, look at King Rice. He's a fighter. He's the Binghamton brawler. Come out of Binghamton, New York.
Duke basketball, they're down by two.
Turnovers.
There's the turnover story, 14 and a half for Carolina.
Well, they have
and they're still ahead.
They have 233 for the year in 14 games.
Nice pass to Laettner. He got away from Chilcutt.
That's the great angle. Nothing like having the 45-degree angle for the entry to the low box. Now they touch the floor. That means they're ready to play defense.
Rice stumbles on the way in, and Laettner fouled him.
They are really battling, Mike. I'll tell you, they are really going after each other. Now, here's the excellent look by Bobby Hurley. He gets the 45-degree angle. There's no help. Throw the bounce pass to the baseline. Now, where's the help? Nobody rotates over. George Lynch, very slow, rotating down to cut off the driving angle.
King Rice goes to the line. Career, he started the season as a 78% free throw shooter, but shooting barely over 60 this year. He's really had a problem.
I watched him in a warm-up out here. Are you ready for this? He knocked down 7 threes in a row. I was watching him from the baseline. I mean, he was knocking 1 three down after another.
That is his first point of the night. And now Larry Rose steps in and talks to Hurley and Rice. He doesn't want to hear it anymore.
Yeah, he doesn't want to have these two guys going at each other.
That's a good officiating move, too.
Play some hoops. And if you don't quiet down, I'm going to call the tee, and I'm going to hit you with the second, and I'm going to send you to the shower.
Rice hits them both, a two-point North Carolina lead, 1:24 left in the half.
There's a lot of pride right now. Rice against Hurley, digging in against each other, two of the better point guards.
Hurley got by Rice and then threw it away.
See, he can't allow that to become a one-on-one battle with Rice, and that created that turnover. He tried to beat him.
Game day at noon Eastern time tomorrow. They will preview both of the conference championships. Then back with all the highlights on NFL primetime at 7:30. Approaching the 1 minute mark. Hill is out on Fox, who goes by him, hangs in the lane and banked it in. Fox is so smooth.
Carolina benching on every play, part of the Dean Smith system, stand and cheer for one another, the family approach.
Rice picking up Hurley all over the court.
Rice is a lot quicker than he looks. He's very deceptively quick.
McCaffrey for three. Laettner with a nice save. Goes up, whistle, travel. Mike Krzyzewski up, he wanted the foul, did not get it.
Mr. Intensity on that sideline. What a career. The last 5 years, four trips to the Final Four.
Boy, the people down here really held their breath when he was talking about taking the Boston Celtics job.
He belongs in college. He made a great move. He's a college coach.
And they loved it when he announced the decision. Carolina will spread the offense, play for the last shot.
Nobody ran the four corners better at North Carolina than Mr. Ford.
Fox. Missed the shot. Duke with a long shot chance with 3 seconds left. Knocked out of bounds to the Blue Devils. And Dean Smith will use that moment to get Montross, his freshman seven-footer, back in the game. This guy doesn't miss anything.
Oh, he's on top of everything. And in practice, he's right on the scene in practice in every drill. He's a teacher.
Hurley trying to beat the clock. Made it close, but no cigar.
Not really a well-played half on the offensive end, Mike, but it's the intensity and the defensive effort that prevail, and that's what's going to happen when you have two quality interstate teams going head-to-head.
Dick, you're right. If you like defense and intensity, we had it all here at Durham, North Carolina. 28-24, North Carolina over Duke. Stay tuned for our halftime show.
Presentation of NCAA basketball, North Carolina versus Duke, is brought to you by Dodge. For performance, quality, safety, and value, welcome home, America. And by Nike, who reminds you to just do it.
Welcome back. The Tar Heels of North Carolina with a 28-24 lead over Duke. The second half still to come, but let's check elsewhere. And we'll start in the ACC, Virginia at Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech, it's been a tough week. A couple of tough losses in conference facing number 14. This time they got back home, though. Matt Geiger, the big man, the transfer from Auburn inside. Here he follows. The offensive rebound sticks it back in. He had 10 rebounds in the first half. Then Geiger defensive boards off Kenny Anderson, finds him for the jam. Georgia Tech up by 17 at halftime. Second half, same thing. Malcolm Mackey follows his own block shot, puts it back up, and Georgia Tech rolls over number 14, 78-51. Kenny Anderson, 21 points in the game, 7 assists, 17 of those points coming in the second half. Georgia Tech out-rebounding the Cavs 52-32. Also in the ACC, NC State down by Wake Forest, 97-76. Rodney Rogers, 23 points, 15 rebounds in the game. NC State, 1 of 17 from three-point range. Temple and Clemson in a non-conference game. The Owls win it 71-52. Mark Macon, 36 points, 8 three-pointers in the game. They won a 30-7 run in the second half. Maryland in a non-conference game facing South Florida on the road, and they're losing 58-44 is that score. Let's move it now to the Big East. Pittsburgh ranked number 16. St. John's ranked number 10. The ranked teams in the Big East. St. John's at home in Jamaica, New York. And Malik Sealy has been Mr. Everything for St. John's this year. The lob. Then defensively, comes up with a block and a steal. Louis Carnesecca likes his junior. Pitt from the outside, Gandy Jordan for three. Then the steal, Darrell Porter comes up with it at the other end and gets the deuce. Pitt stays in the game, but St. John's at home up at halftime by 7, 34-27. A non-conference game, another Big East school, Villanova at home, DuPont hosting number 6, Arizona and the Wildcats. It was a battle of the Wildcats, actually. Chris Mills, three-pointer, the bounce, and it goes in. Then Mark Dowdell, tough basket inside, and he's fouled. Rolly Massimino with the applause for that one. Chris Mills with a jumper. Matt Muehlbach finishes it off. And Arizona beats Villanova in a game that Nova was in until just about the end. Lute Olson, reason to smile now. Arizona wins it 72-64. Chris Mills, 26 points and 9 rebounds in the game. Villanova shooting just 43%. In the Big East, Seton Hall, 25 against number 8 at Syracuse. And Seton Hall, the Pirates up 33-26 at halftime. Also in the Big East, Providence playing in Hartford against Connecticut. Connecticut with 55 points already in the contest, still in the first half. Providence down 55-42 at this point. Georgetown on the road at Boston College. down 2 in a low-scoring affair at halftime, 24-22. The news in this game is Alonzo Mourning is back in the lineup for the Georgetown Hoyas. He did wind up on the floor in the first half. Stay with us when we come back. We'll take a look at the Big Ten. Indiana and Iowa still to come. Highlights of that game as we continue at halftime in the ACC in a four-point contest. Big Monday comes your way. It'll be our third edition of the year in just a couple of days, and Indiana and Ohio State will be featured in the Big Ten. Indiana in action tonight, ranked number 3 in the nation, facing Iowa, number 24, though the Hawkeyes coming off a surprising loss to Wisconsin. Calvert Chaney nails a three-pointer from the right side. Lyndon Jones is back in Bobby Knight's starting lineup. He gets a three as well. Lyndon Jones and finds Damon Bailey, the freshman, pulls up along the baseline, hits the jumper. Dr. Tom Davis trying to fight off a tough week, but they lead in the first half. 37-36 is the score. Hoosiers have won 13 straight. Hawkeyes have won 10 straight at home. Something has to give there. It's also in the Big Ten. Ohio State, the Buckeyes, up 30-27 at home against Illinois at halftime. Best start for the Buckeyes. They right now are 14-0 since 62-63. Southwest Conference, SMU down to number 2 Arkansas. No surprise here, 54-33 at halftime. In the SEC, Vanderbilt beaten by Kentucky this afternoon. Wildcats 6-0 in conference, but they cannot go to the tournament. They're still on probation, 58-50. Jamal Mashburn, outstanding freshman, 17 points there. In the Big 8, Oklahoma State couldn't hang on against Oklahoma, losing at 76-72. Brent Price, 17 points, including 3 three-pointers. In the SEC again, Mississippi and LSU. LSU up 26-18 in the first half. They won 16 straight at home against Ole Miss. Southern Conference, number 15, East Tennessee State over Western Carolina, 93-76. The Bucks are now 14-1, best start in the history of the school. Metro Conference, Memphis State beaten by Southern Miss, 87-77. Elliott Perry, 24 points and 7 assists in that contest. And Florida State over South Carolina in overtime, 81-80 was the final there. Chuck Graham, 17 points. Aubrey Boyd had 16 points. JoJo English, 25, but in the losing cause. Stay with us. Back with more in just a moment. We're at halftime in the ACC in a four-point contest. But right now, let's take a look at some more scores on this Saturday night, including Michigan State.
It's a known fact.
Now with 31 consecutive losses at home. Let's continue with another highlight and some scores. Michigan and Wisconsin, this out of the Big Ten. Michigan and Wisconsin. Wisconsin, a surprising team this past week. Michigan, a bit of a down year, but Tony Tolbert, 8 seconds left, pulls, nails a 15-footer, 69-68 Wolverines. Tolbert thought he had won the game, but a foul was called on teammate Michael Talley. 2 free throws for Wisconsin. Larry Heisel missed the first. Tied the game, misses the second. Chance to send the game to double overtime, and the Wolverines win it. 69-68 is the final, overcoming a 14-point halftime deficit. Michael Talley with 18 points in the game. A reminder, still one more game to come here on ESPN later tonight following SportsCenter at midnight Eastern time. We'll go to the WAC. BYU will face Wyoming. Sean Bradley, the outstanding rookie center, big guy at 7'6 for BYU. You want to have a chance to see him play. So stay with us. There's still more to come. We're at halftime in the ACC. 4-point lead for the Tar Heels. ESPN's
presentation of NCAA basketball. North Carolina versus Duke is brought to you by Cadillac and your local Cadillac dealer. Discover why the only way to travel is Cadillac style. And by Budweiser, the king of beers. Remember, know when to say when.
We're at halftime in Durham, North Carolina, where the Tar Heels lead the Blue Devils 28-24. Keep in mind that these are both teams that average more than 91 points a game. So we have had some defense. Mike Patrick, Dick Vitale, glad you could join us tonight. And we set it up at the beginning by saying it would be a great battle to watch between King Rice and Bobby Hurley.
Well, they really went at each other in terms on the defensive end. Both have made some major mistakes offensively. King Rice really set the offense up. He had some great looks. There's one great look. He had four assists, no turnovers in the first half. That's the Chilcutt on a back screen. King Rice in his last, forget about the number of points, 2 points. He's the leader. He wants to play on the defensive end as well. On the other side, when we talk about Duke, Duke has a little simple message. It says, let's play defense when they touch the floor. Watch this. They all touch the floor. That means we're ready to play defense. And look at Hurley now. He's talking. He's running his mouth. He's moaning and groaning right now to Rice. He says, you can't beat me, Rice. You can't beat me. And there's the loose ball, first and 10.
Well, that time they played 49er defense. Yeah. You know, they knocked him down, got a foul out of it. Take a look at the first half stats. Duke has not shot well the entire game, only 33% at the half, and neither team has been able to hit a three-pointer. 0-for-4 and 0-for-6. A total of 0-for-10 between these clubs.
Defense has really kept Duke in the game. When you're shooting 33%, but you allow a high-powered offense like North Carolina, only 28 points, you have yourself a chance to win, especially in your own living room floor.
The shooting picked up considerably in the closing minutes of the first half. Carolina basketball as we start the second half with Rice. Slapped away, another fight for it. Behind the back, now tipped. And Duke basketball as Crawford Palmer came up with a loose one. Hill tries to reverse layup. It's blocked inside by Chilcutt. Hill again, over Chilcutt.
What a second effort by Hill.
Grant Hill has four. The lead is cut to two. Crawford Palmer starting the second half inside, and he'll pick up the foul.
George
battling with Lynch.
Lynch trying to get post positions inside. Grant Hill all over the top of him, trying to beat him to the spot with some post defense.
Rice will inbound.
Grant Hill's going to be a special player at Duke. He's got All-American across his chest in the future.
Maybe a couple of guys on this floor who will have that designation.
What an unselfish play by Fox. He had the good look at the basket, but he found Lynch wide open, dumped it down for the layup.
Lynch has six. The lead goes back to four. Laettner, great catch. I don't think the basket will count. It will not.
Laettner uses either hand as well as anyone in college basketball. He's going to get a lot of help next year, too. Next year, I project that Duke will be a top five team all year, returning the nucleus they have. And then you add to Bob Hurley and Billy McCaffrey, Mike Krzyzewski and Peter Godet have done a tremendous job of recruiting. They have a kid by the name of Cherokee Parks. Remember when you see him, Michael, he is the real thing at about 6'11 from California.
Last foul was on George Lynch, his second, the first against Carolina here in the final half. Laettner and Chilcutt, 32 against 32. Hurley for three. 0 for 11 for both teams. Laettner with a follow.
Christian Laettner with the good offensive rebound. Gets the quick move to the basket.
Laettner has 10. It's 30-28. Lynch inside Palmer.
George Lynch is so tough once he gets that post position down in the box. You have to three-quarter him or front him. You can't allow him to get the ball in that deep.
Here's a moving screen called against Palmer. That will be his third foul.
Points of emphasis this year by the officials. The moving screen. We'll see some screens Monday night. Hoosiers, Indiana, Ohio State, Buckeyes, Calvert Chaney against Jimmy Jackson. Monday night, a big Monday.
Number three against number four. Are we looking forward to that from Bloomington? Back door, Chilcutt, nice catch, had it knocked away inside. They'll call the foul on Grant Hill, his second.
Excellent hands by Chilcutt, and he got free on a single reverse move. A single reverse, pinning the defensive player to the baseline and flipping the ball up on top. He's from out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama. His numbers have really been impressive. In fact, he just passed James Worthy in the rebounding totals for his career at North Carolina.
Well, he's out of the suburbs. He's from Utah, Alabama.
He played in high school, though, in Tuscaloosa. And he got away from Wim Sanderson.
Well, we don't want to slight Utah, Alabama.
You mentioned
Chilcutt, 8 points on the night.
You mentioned Utah, University of Utah. What a job Rick Majerus is doing.
Lead is six. Here's full court pressure again. Hurley double team.
Post in the middle.
Oh, and throw it right to Hubert Davis. Back to Rice. Boy, excellent defense by Palmer, and Rice may have been better advised to pull up. McCaffrey waited, got it blocked, but he's fouled.
Most of the time, because of intimidation, you would walk in that scenario. But Billy McCaffrey kept his foot pivoted. George Lynch just loves to play. Always has a smile on his face.
Third foul on Lynch.
I look at Hurley and I look at McCaffrey and I think they belong in the CYO. Look at this young looking guy. He has played so much intense basketball in his career, both on a scholastic and collegiate level. And as a look at Billy McCaffrey, comes from a great athletic family, brother to wide receiver, tore the Fighting Irish apart for Stanford. What a receiver his brother is.
Best free throw shooter in the ACC entering the week. He was number four in the country, has 2 points tonight.
You talk about great free throw shooters. One of the assets they have at North Carolina State is he misses the free throw. Corciani and Moreau both shoot better than 80%. And when your two outstanding backcourt players can do that, and they're going to be on the floor at the end of the game, you got a chance to win, even though today they were blown out by Wake Forest.
Well, the Duke fans gave McCaffrey a nice round of applause. They're trying to support him. He drills the second. It's 34-29, Carolina by five, 18 minutes to go in the game. Chilcutt looked for the back door, and then it's intercepted by Grant Hill, and he's fouled by Fox.
Yeah, Fox tripped him. He grabbed his leg. Fox from out of the Bahamas, one of my all foreign players. I have no problem with them coming over to play here as long as they fulfill their 4 years. It's the hired gun that I get really upset about, the guy that comes in for the 1 year, and then he disappears, doesn't have his degree, just comes in and plays. And off he goes, back to his foreign land.
And then goes back and plays for his national team in the Olympics.
Exactly.
Duke fans trying to keep their club in the game. 9,314, as always, at Cameron Indoor. McCaffrey trying to get away from Davis, can't.
They've done an excellent job on McCaffrey, really locking him up. Great fake by Bobby Hurley.
But he missed the shot, the outside shot not falling.
That's an athlete.
Lynch. Tripped up, missed the shot. Rebound to Laettner.
No one gets easy layups because of the excellent defensive transition of both clubs.
Here's the double team. McCaffrey almost threw it away. Laettner with a good catch again. Great hands by Laettner. Palmer, and excellent defense by Chilcutt to knock it away.
They're really telegraphing their passes, Mike. You can read and anticipate where they're going to make that pass.
Chilcutt. He may have been pushed by Laettner. Got away with one.
They did get away with one.
That's what Dean's saying.
Dean Smith is really animated on the sideline because of a little push and no call.
Chilcutt wanted to go straight up and ended up going up at a 45-degree angle away from the basket. McCaffrey for three. Laettner offensive rebound. Chilcutt cuts him off.
What an excellent passer Laettner is.
McCaffrey inside the three-point line, and he got that one.
Excellent ball reversal. McCaffrey squares his body, gets the great look at the hoop, but the excellent ball reversal, swinging it from side to side, created a three-point opportunity.
5 points for McCaffrey. The lead is cut to three.
And the Cameron Crazies erupt.
Fox guarded by Grant Hill. Pull-up is way short. Follow tipped away by Laettner.
That was excellent one-on-one defense by Grant Hill on Rick Fox, not allowing him to beat him with the first step. He squared his shoulders with him. He had the good look at him, and he really said, no, Fox, you're not going to beat me to the goal.
15:59 to go from Durham. It's a three-point Carolina lead. Well, we call it Big Monday. Maybe we ought to call it Very Big Monday this time. Syracuse against Georgetown at 7:30. Mike Gorman and Bill Raftery. And Dick and I will be in Bloomington. Ohio State against Indiana. And then Barry Tompkins and Quinn Buckner will bring you UNLV against Cal State Santa Barbara. What a lineup Monday night on ESPN. Carolina leads by three. Montross. Laettner lost it. Fox has it. Laettner's played a lot of minutes in there.
And played well, especially on a defensive end.
Rice by Hurley. Finger roll comes up way short. Outlet to
what
Hurley.
Great Fox outlet.
Is back. Hill. Pinned on the board by Lindstedt, calling for his fourth foul.
That was created by a tremendous outlet. This guy just loves to play. Look at the jubilation on his face. He says, no, I got the ball. But what a tremendous outlet. First of all, Laettner stops the penetration. He closes the driving angle. There's the Wes Unseld look. Here comes Hurley. He draws the defense to him. Fox. He dumps it to his buddy. Lynch rotates back. He's got the great legs.
Well, Lynch made the great block, but he did get him with the body, and that is four on Lynch, the fourth team foul against North Carolina in the second half.
Always smiling, just loves to play. It's so great to see an athlete enjoying what they're doing instead of pouting.
He's out of Roanoke, Virginia, a sophomore. That's a very young club mixed in with three seniors.
He played at Flint Hill Prep. They produced so many great players, including the Dennis Scott.
Hill now has 7 points. And the lead is cut to two.
Laettner says, I like that, sir, Tom. That's the way to deliver that free throw.
He's hit 3 for 3. Could cut the lead to 1 at this point. And does.
That's the touch.
34-33.
They have really stayed in this game because of their defense. Their offensive execution has been really not what Duke's.
Nice fake by Fox, lost it out of bounds, out to Duke.
Again, defense.
Here's some scores. St. John's leading Pitt, that's a second half. Georgetown by 1 over Boston College, also a second half
Georgetown's
score.
Really been struggling without Mr. Morning. Malik Sealy is the most improved player in college basketball.
17 turnovers by Carolina, and we have 15 minutes to go. Laettner leans in, partially blocked. The follow by Hill is good. Excuse me,
that
Lang.
Was Antonio Lang. Lang, who was injured in the first half, has good offensive positioning.
King Rice fouled on the way in by Hurley.
We have seen two unbelievable intrastate battles this week. By watching Purdue and Indiana go over Mackey Arena with 13,000 went wild. And here tonight with North Carolina and Duke. This rivalry, someone asked me, how would you rate this rivalry versus North Carolina and North Carolina State? I think this one's much bigger.
This is the last first time since Duke has led since 6-4. Rodel tried to get it to Montross. Laettner knocked it away. McCaffrey has it. Fox knocked it away from him. Boy, it doesn't get much louder than this either.
What makes this place so special? Not only the noise and the loudness, they line up for over a week so they can get the opportunity to see their heroes perform.
Hill open for three.
What a job he has done off the bench. Tom Hill is a streaky shooter, and he has got the rhythm tonight.
Before that shot, he had only made 8 3-pointers all year. 38-34 Duke.
This is a big possession. North Carolina psychologically needs a score here.
Rodel had it blocked by Laettner.
Laettner owning the defensive end.
Hurley for Hill. Couldn't catch it.
And they tried for the big spectacular play.
Rice trying to get by Hurley. Lost the ball. Fouled by Hurley.
Hurley gets the foul reaching in.
That's two on Hurley.
Bobby Hurley, his second, 15th foul. Brian Davis and Greg Kubek return to the Blue Devils.
Dean Smith goes to his bench. Reese will come in. Derek Phelps will also come in. Crawford Palmer comes in for Duke. Lang will get a rest. Laettner comes out for a breather. So does Fox. So the wheels are turning on both benches.
Christian Laettner is a complete player. He can pass the ball. He plays on the defensive end. He can rebound. He goes inside, outside.
And with a 38-34 lead, Mike Krzyzewski can afford to rest him at least for a little bit. Chilcutt fouled by Kubek.
Don't want to put Chilcutt on the line. He's an excellent free throw shooter.
That's one on Kubek. That's the sixth team foul against Duke.
I'll never forget Chilcutt's big basket, his first start. J.R. Reed can't play. He's suspended. They play against Syracuse, number one in the nation, Hall of Fame classic, and he tips it in to win the game.
73% from the line.
We spoke about it a little bit earlier. His brother, Michael, who was going to be stationed in Camp Lejeune this year, and he was really hoping that his brother could have seen all his games, but his brother right now is in the Persian Gulf.
As Operation Desert Storm continues, we at ESPN encourage everyone to put sports in its proper context. Our thoughts and our prayers go out to the servicemen and women stationed in the Persian Gulf and their families.
Certainly echo those sentiments, Mike.
Thomas Hill got the last basket. Duke back by four.
Hill with that good athletic ability along the baseline.
Chilcutt threw the ball where Hubert Davis wasn't.
Duke has really picked it up defensively, and they have Carolina out of sync.
Carolina will send Pat Sullivan into the game for the first time. He's number three, a freshman out of New Jersey.
I really like him. He's one of those complimentary players that really knows how to play the game from out of Pagoda, New Jersey.
Pressure on the inbounds pass picked off. Phelps with a miss. The follow shot won't go. It's tipped in. And it's 40-38.
I love the stance of Phelps. Look at the stance of Phelps defensively.
Chilcutt got credit for the last bucket. He has a dozen.
Low center of gravity. Beat him to a spot. Drive him. Beat him. Take him away from his strength. See, that's his strength. Don't allow him to get in there.
Hurley trying to go all the way underneath. And Phelps will draw the foul. That's his first.
If you allow a guy of Hurley's ability to start to penetrate the lane, that's where good things happen, because now when he draws the help, he can dish the ball to open people on the boxes.
Bobby Hurley has not scored tonight. He averages 12.5 points a game.
And he had a big game against Maryland, 26. He worked so hard against Georgia Tech when they came here with Kenny Anderson.
McCaffrey's been held to five, and he averages 14. You saw the free throw story.
Carolina's bench very deep. They have a lot of people they can rotate. A tremendous balance. A la Indiana. That's one of the strengths of Indiana. Play great defense, rotate 9 or 10 people.
Hurley tonight, 6 assists, but 8 costly turnovers. He'll get a breather right here with a club up 42-38.
When you're a distributor of the rock like Bob Hurley, you have to have at least a 2-to-1 ratio, assist to turnovers. And tonight he is minus.
Chilcutt, fall away jumper.
He's got the great touch. He has that excellent release, good rotation, soft.
14 points for Chilcutt, the lead cut to 2. Reese on Grant Hill.
Grant Hill playing the point. 6'7.5. Smooth. Can handle the rock. Can slide inside as well. Post on a little guard.
Thomas Hill working against Davis. McCaffrey, pass almost picked off. Can't get the roll, and Grant Hill goes over the back and commits his third foul.
Peter Chilcutt. Grant Hill, what a family he comes from. You talk about class, talk to Calvin Hill and his lovely wife, Janet, and you see nothing but class in that family.
There's Calvin Hill right in the middle of your picture, wearing a baseball cap.
He's with the Baltimore Orioles now. Big executive.
Boy, was he a great running back. And you're right, Dick. He was the epitome of class, a player and a person.
Well, he went to Yale University, so he had his priorities in order academically as well as athletically. And his son was recruited by everyone, but fell in love with his visit here to Durham.
Chilcutt with 14. Missed. That was a one and one. Could have tied it. Instead, Duke has the ball and a two-point lead with 12 minutes to go in the game. McCaffrey, they get over on him.
Duke likes to utilize that skip pass.
Crawford Palmer with an air ball from 4 feet, and he goes in and gets a jump ball. Nice job to tie up Brian.
And alternate possession goes to Duke. Crawford had no look at the basket, Mike. His angle was really, really very tough for him to get a good look.
11:50 to go in the ball game. Duke leading North Carolina 42-40. Krzyzewskiville on the outskirts of Cameron Indoor Stadium. Those are the rules if you want to belong to this population, which grew to over 1,600 in the 2 weeks before this game. Where I grew up in West Virginia, a lot of cities around me had less than 1,600.
Hey, I'll tell
you what. Here's a swipe at you.
Well, because I said Loot Mania, they deserve it this year with their tremendous winning streak down in Arizona. But there's no question this is the best environment in terms of the total environment.
Kubek with a follow, and he got it. That was a big bucket because they had a set play off the inbounds, and McCaffrey missed the jumper. Kubek got the offensive rebound and put it back.
They need some productivity out of Kubek. He's too good a player not to be a real productive player off the bench. He's got a lot of experience.
Great pass to King Rice. He missed the shot, but he's fouled by Hurley. And what a pass by Rick Fox.
Excellent pass by Fox, but Duke broke down defensively, had no vision of the ball, and man, you know, they got a little upset because I had said Loot Mania in Arizona. McHale was the place that I voted midseason as the best environment because they're winning. They're winning like crazy up there, Mike. And those fans are going wild out in Arizona.
Now, Dean Smith and Mike Krzyzewski are in midcourt. They're pointing at the possession arrow or the number of team fouls. It had to do with the number of team fouls.
Mike Krzyzewski, a graduate of West Point, 1969, coached at West Point.
King Rice with 2 points. We'll go to the line where he's a 62% free throw shooter.
They really contained him more offensively because he's had so many big days against Duke.
Boy, and he has been talking up the storm to Bobby Hurley tonight. That's been their tradition. Rice missed them both. Laettner is back in there for Duke, so they have the inside scoring threat again. And they lead by four with 11:15 to go.
Always looking to get the good angle for an entry inside.
McCaffrey had it blocked by Davis, saved by Lynch. He sails into the stands. Great hustle by George Lynch, who's out there with four fouls.
He's working and working, trying to improve his perimeter game to go along with his inside baseline ability. When it works, when it experienced officials talking to Duke Etzel, little Leonard.
He's a I think giant. It's a question of where the ball will be inbounded.
He's refereed a few big games in his time.
Hasn't he, though? And done it well, too. Having trouble getting it in. Barely beat the 5 second count. McCaffrey blocked from behind. Chilcutt. Duke got it back. Boys, there have been some great defense tonight. Hurley all the way around. Drops it for Laettner, and he got it.
What an excellent two-man play. Hurley with the penetration. He breaks the defense down, and then he gets the good look to his buddy Laettner. He says, thanks a lot, Christian.
That one was world class.
I mean, he was really determined. Here he is, going to break the defense down. He blows by Lynch. He draws Chilcutt to him. He dumps it down to Laettner. What a tremendous two-man play. As good as you can find.
Foul was called on Fox, his third, the sixth team foul against North Carolina. Christian Laettner now has 13 points.
Excellent touch by Laettner on that free throw line. He's one of the, if you right now had a look through America and pick the top 10 players in the nation, I want Christian Laettner as one of my top 10.
Biggest lead of the game for the Blue Devils. Carolina had led by 10 in the first half. Rodel and Rice in the backcourt for North Carolina.
They don't really have a whole lot of backcourt scoring right now with Rice and Rodel on the floor. Look at the zone defense right now. Duke has changed to a zone.
And they exploit it by getting Fox to run the baseline behind it.
They throw it right over the top of the zone. Duke really not an experienced team zone. And Mike Krzyzewski tries to throw it a little different look.
Hill gives it back to Hurley. We approach the 10-minute mark. It's a 5-point Duke lead at home.
I'll bet the next possession you'll see Duke back in a man-to-man. Fox matched up on a point.
McCaffrey, Laettner lost it inside. Fox for three. Chilcutt kept it alive. Tipped outside. Duke ball. Kubek. McCaffrey.
Great play by McCaffrey to keep both pivot feet planted and not be intimidated and have the walk-in violation. And he hits the trail man.
And Jam Thomas City. Hill just racing down the lane.
Thomas Hill's been the star of stars tonight.
Almost stolen again.
He's come off the bench for a tremendous lift.
Thomas Hill has 15 points tonight.
Inside, outside, he's hit some perimeter shots, knocked down a three. Has really run the court exceptionally well.
Chilcutt and Laettner, what a matchup, and Chilcutt lost it this time.
I'll tell you, life in the ACC can be wacky. Duke gets blown out by Virginia by 17. They blow away Georgia Tech by 40, and today Georgia Tech blows Virginia away. But as the trap, just post somebody up, look for the diagonal.
Boy, good job by Hurley. He just called timeout and said, see you later.
Good timeout, but that's not where he wants to bring the basketball against the trap.
9-12 to go in the game. Duke 49, North Carolina 42.
On guard for ACC Big East Wednesday, Duke's Bobby Hurley meets NC State's fire and ice combo of Corksi and Monroe. Then Pitt tries to stop Eric Murdoch of Providence. Wednesday night, live on ESPN.
Billy McCaffrey does a great job of keeping his pivot feet down. Now look, he knows the trail is coming. He keeps the pivot, and there's Hill with Jam City. A little dipsy-doo dunkaroo. Mr. Hill's been so productive off the bench.
Hill leads Duke with 15. Laettner has 13. Only one player in double figures for North Carolina, and that's Chilcutt. He has 14 tonight. And Duke will have to use another timeout because they can't get the ball in. And Mike Krzyzewski is boiling.
I don't blame
9-12 to go. 49-42. We'll be back in a moment.
1985, 86, 87, 88, 89. For six straight years, the full-size pickup from GMC truck has retained more of its original value than any other in America. That's why sales of the Sierra are growing faster than any other full-size pickup. And we intend to keep it that way in 1991 with these new Sierras. And in 92, GMC truck. It's not just a truck anymore. It's quality on the road. Why does a man have to do what a man has to do?
Two, three, four.
Try Bud Dry. Cold filtered for smooth draft taste. Dry brewed for no aftertaste. Refreshing proof that men still know what they're doing.
The Adenorex side really feels like it's doing a lot more than the Head and Shoulders side. It feels real cool and tingly over here.
Both have a dandruff ingredient, but Adenorex adds an extra anti-itch medicine you can feel working.
The tingle told me that Adenorex was doing more for my hair.
Powerful. It's 110% protection. Speed Stick deodorant, made just for a man. It has no alcohol to evaporate. Its protection doesn't fade. Speed Stick, 110% protection. By men.
9 minutes, 12 seconds to play from Durham, North Carolina. Duke up by seven. And Duke ball, they only have one timeout left. They have squandered a pair back to back. Hurley just inside the three-point line. Laettner kept it alive and Hurley got it.
Laettner with those long arms.
One timeout, Dick, is not the situation a coach wants with 9 minutes to go in the game.
Especially a big-time major college basketball team that can't put the ball in play from the sideline or baseline. That's a no-no.
And Duke making North Carolina spread its defense.
They're going to look for the high percentage shot. Use some of the shot clock. This is not a stall.
McCaffrey comes out. Fox trying to deny Hurley the ball. It's a size mismatch right there. Shot clock, and Hurley forced by Fox with some excellent defense to do what he didn't want to do.
He had 10 turnovers last year in the first meeting against North Carolina. Tonight he has 9 turnovers.
As you saw some Big East scores passed your way.
He's too good a player when we speak about Bob Hurley to turn the ball over as often as he does.
Well, I think King Rice, as was detailed by both players earlier, really gets his juices flowing. 8:25 left in the game. Kubek will come out. Antonio Lang is back in.
They trade experience for athletic ability. More size inside.
And look at all the substitutions both coaches have made. And we still have 8:17 to go.
That's only 62 between them.
That's right. Chilcutt guarded by Laettner. Rozier.
Poor Les Robinson down at North Carolina State. He can't make any substitutions.
Rozier with a backdoor pass. Fox for three. Carolina will come out with a Chilcutt chase it down in the corner, but then they throw it away. Dick, you just get that feeling that Fox or somebody from North Carolina is going to catch the hot hand, but it hasn't happened yet.
Dean Smith's certainly hoping for it to happen. Rozier is capable of giving them good offensive productivity.
This is a big game. These are the top two teams in the conference. You must win at home. So it's bigger for Duke to win tonight than it is North Carolina.
Two of the better teams in America. Oh, Lang with a little single reverse gets mugged inside. He's got to blow the whistle.
Rozier is called for his fourth foul.
The toughest adjustment for young people like Rozier coming into major college is playing defense man-to-man along that baseline.
Lynch will come back in. Rozier will go out with his fourth foul. Lynch has four.
Oh, look, look, he's hugging him. He's hugging him. He's hooking him. You can't do that, Clifford.
7:38 left.
Put it down. This kid is going to be an excellent player at North Carolina. Mike Krzyzewski says, Dick, I really believe he's going to become one of their outstanding front court players.
Lang, first trip to the free throw line. He shoots under 50%. That's his fifth point on the night and a big one because he gives Duke an 8-point lead.
First time I ever met Antonio Lang. I was preparing for a game and I was sitting in Dale Brown's office at LSU and he walked in with his dad. And let me tell you something. I heard about his transcript, 4.0 valedictorian. I said, wow.
Now, the rest of the story is he saw you with Dale Brown and decided to come here, right? Oh. 51-42. The biggest lead of the game. Duke up by 9, 7.5 minutes left. Fox tries to get it inside. Kubek has played some outstanding defense tonight.
The Duke team defense has really done an excellent job. Right there is one of the phases of their defense. Beat the cutter to the ball. Four basic principles taken from the Bobby Knight system. Pressure the ball, deny on a wing, beat the cutter to the ball, a block out.
Boy, another hustling play this time by McCaffrey. And Dick, if memory serves correct, when Kubek played earlier in his career, he was not being put in the lineup for defense, but he's come through for them this season.
Yeah, he really has. He was put in the lineup earlier in his career for shooting ability.
Chilcutt way outside as they start the offense.
Well, they pride themselves on good man defense.
Lynch. Boy, every pass is a contest. Fox for three, won't go. And another rebound for Christian Laettner.
Christian Laettner is so quick to the basketball. He anticipates exceptionally well.
That is 11 rebounds for the big junior out of Angola, New York.
backdoor cut. They miss Hurley. He was wide open. Back. Wide open.
Six for Kubek, and the lead has grown to 11.
Kubek hits the J, Mike, but he had Hurley wide open. Dean's got to be concerned. Coach Guthridge sitting to his right. He'd like to substitute and put the guy behind him in the game by the name of Mr. Ford, Philip Ford.
Both teams have been told they cannot touch the ball after it goes through the basket. It's a delay of game call.
That's
Here's Phil Ford. Well, when he ran the four corners, you could forget it. You never got the ball back.
Hey, I waved the handkerchief when we played against him in Detroit. As soon as they got the lead and gave him the rock, we put the white hanky up.
Carolina needs a basket here very badly. But it's tough to decide who to go to. Nobody's been hot. Nobody's done anything except Chilcutt.
Hill gets caught for holding on to Fox defensively.
That's one foul for Thomas Hill. Here's some other scores. Indiana leading Iowa. That's with 13 minutes to go.
And that's at Iowa.
And Ohio State on top of Illinois by 19. That would set up our Big Monday confrontation between Ohio State and Indiana at Bloomington.
I'll tell you, Bloomington, Indiana is always a special place to be as well. You see all the red, and then when Knight walks in, it's like their hero, and a place just erupts. Columbus is another special place. Have you ever done a game in Missouri or Texas, South Carolina?
South Carolina, yes.
I've never done a game in any of those places.
Missouri and Texas, I have not.
I'd love to go to those three environments for a game. I heard they're really special.
Fox, 9 points on the night. The lead is cut to 10. Every possession will become very important now for North Carolina.
North Carolina will probably go into a trap right now after the score.
Fox hits them both, and Reese will check back in. Fox will get a rest.
Put Reese in with the fresh legs. Very athletic, tremendous leaper.
Chilcutt inbounds to Grant Hill, and they find Hurley. 6:33 to go.
He's going to try to invite him to a trap. Here comes the run and jump. See, they got to post somebody to the middle of the floor.
Grant Hill with that cross-court pass. Hill, Thomas Hill, that is. What a pass to Laettner! Best pass Hurley's made all night.
They really look for each other. I believe that was McCaffrey that made that pass.
Yeah, you're right. Here's the block inside by Thomas Hill.
Thomas Hill's been unbelievable all night long. He's been Superman. Put an S on his chest, Mr. Hill.
55-44.
He's got to make my all-Rolaid special, my best 6 men in basketball.
Hubert Davis, who's been off all night. Loose ball inside. There's the foul. Sullivan got the rebound.
I've done a number of games this year with Duke. This is the best team defense they have played in the games that I've seen them before, Mike.
That's the fourth foul on Grant Hill.
Thomas Hill rotates over with the left hand, has the great angle because of the left hand. If he was a right-handed player, there's a guy that teaches defense, a disciple of the General Robert Montgomery Knight. And here's the star of stars tonight, Thomas Hill.
Had a sensational game. Sullivan averages less than 2 points a game.
Hasn't had a whole lot of PT.
No, he's way down the minutes list for this club.
And everybody I talk to really believes he's going to be a solid college player.
He got to start the game you and I did against Notre Dame up in the Meadowlands.
You mentioned Notre Dame. What a tough luck for Digger Phelps. They just lost Alfonso Ellis academically.
Oh. As if they didn't have enough problems.
Well, they had two tough breaks, losing Monty Williams before the start of the season. But you're right, he started Reese and he started Sullivan. He does that whenever he takes his team to an area where he has a player from that area.
55-46.
Very tough to trap this Duke team. They're so well drilled, they space exceptionally well. Look at that screen.
Big screen by Laettner.
So they'll use the clock, take the high percentage shot.
They're gonna have to ask Phelps where he is. Hurley brings it back out. 5:27 and counting. Hurley got by, then missed the shot.
The ball slipped out of his hands. He had a good angle for the layup.
And Carolina throws it away on the other end.
North Carolina totally struggling offensively.
23 turnovers for North Carolina tonight. It is very tough to win anywhere, particularly at Duke when you turn it over that much.
Their turnover ratio has been very high throughout the entire year.
McCaffrey beats the press. Kubek for three. Good night.
feels it tonight. What bench productivity they have received from Hill and Kubek.
Sullivan, double pump, forced it up. Hurley. Mike Krzyzewski says, don't run, hold it up. Run the clock.
He wants to go to the motion game. They'll go foul line extended. They'll bring it out, trying to get the back door cut. There it is.
Hurley, good presence of mind to bring it back outside.
See, they try to get a foul line extended so he can't give any help defensively. They'll lay a lot of back screens. Oh, there's a mugging right there. Sullivan gets nailed.
Sullivan called for his first. It'll be a 1-1, and Dean Smith brings four new bodies back into the game. Montross is in, Rice, Fox. Lynch is back on the court, so is Hubert Davis. That's the lineup he'll go with. Thomas Hill, Kubek, McCaffrey, Grant Hill, and Laettner out there for Duke.
This Duke team has played some sensational defense tonight, Mike.
Boy, haven't they.
And I think it's a reflection of the crowd. They really have given them a tremendous lift all night long.
And the foul will go against Carolina, going for the rebound. And it's on Montross.
Has a look at this environment. The students right on top of the scene. That's what makes it so special. They really give the students the priority here.
And that's the way it ought to be, Dick.
Oh, I think
it's their school. 15 points for Christian Laettner. He's 1 out of 2 from the line.
He's really been worth about 30 points with his rebound and his defense tonight.
Missed that one. Very unusual for Laettner to miss free throws. Duke still up by 12, 4:20 to go. Grant Hill on King Rice. Fox for three.
That would have been a 4-point play.
He was fouled. And now one of the rare opportunities. Are they going to say it was on the shot or after the shot?
It was on the shot. He should get 3 attempts.
It's like the old NBA 3-to-make-2.
They rotate the ball over. Here comes Fox. There's the release. And there's the wrist.
Bobby Hurley replacing Thomas Hill.
That's 2 on Thomas Hill. North Carolina has averaged over 5 three-pointers a game made this year. Tonight, they are 0-for-6.
Look at a hug by Mike. Says, I love it. Keep it up. I just love it. You played really well, Thomas. Did a great job so far tonight.
Rick Fox, who averages nearly 17 points a game, has 10 tonight.
Hasn't had too many open shots.
No,
every
sure.
shot is really contested.
Nobody's had very many open
shots. They're really
shots.
All contested.
You get them tonight, you earn them.
It's the 3. I used to hate that rule in the NBA.
3-to-make-2.
And then you see some guys in the NBA making big money, and they go 0-for-3 to take the hat trick.
I guess why they did away with it.
I just thought it was very boring.
Fox will get another one. A chance to cut the lead to single digits. And does. 4:16 left.
As the trail man against the trap.
Hurley back in there to handle the ball.
And look for a run and jump situation.
Felt
Fox,
on him.
There comes Fox. Post the guy up to the middle. Hit the post. I want to coach him up here.
Hurley gets it out to McCaffrey. Has the wide open shot. Takes it. The rebound to Lynch. Shot clock still had plenty of time on it. Knocked out of bounds out to North Carolina. I don't know if that's the shot Mike Krzyzewski would have liked to have had.
Well, he would have liked to have it if it went down.
Yeah.
He said, pretty good shot, pretty good shot.
Chilcutt over Laettner. Rebound to Hurley. Now, down the stretch, keep in mind, Duke, one of the better free throw shooting teams in the country. So that's it's tough to go out and foul him.
That's that special situations we spoke about earlier.
Good anticipation by Phelps. Stripped on the way in, out to North Carolina.
Phelps teamed up in high school with Khalid Reeves, who now plays at Arizona. Adrian Autry at Syracuse hooked up with Brian Reese. New York City had so many great athletes last year.
3:24 to go in the game. Duke by 9, North Carolina basketball. Hubert Davis will trigger it in. this is a guy capable of scoring. Fox and McCaffrey reached in and whacked him. That could have easily been an intentional foul.
Number one, that's going to stop the clock, put him on a free throw line. He can get this down to seven.
So Fox goes back to the line where he is 5 for 5 with 13 points tonight.
Blue Heavens, you talk about Carolina and their tradition. Dean Smith, 30 years. I can't even begin to think to win 700 or more games in 30 years. I mean, you don't have to be a mathematical genius to realize that averages out to better than 25 a year.
Mike Patrick and Dick Vitale, you're watching college basketball at its best on ESPN. It's Duke 58, North Carolina 50. We're in Durham, North Carolina with 3:20 to go in the game.
And what makes him so special, he is one with class.
58-51, Hurley, a lot of contact, the ball knocked out of bounds, out to Carolina, and Phelps caused that.
Duke's got to regroup. They knocked down a three here. This can get really interesting. He knows it's not over. You see his intensity.
Still plenty of time. 3:18 to go. That's 18 turnovers for Duke. They haven't exactly protected the ball against pressure very well either.
Well, that's again because of the Carolina defense. It's been a defensive performance. Haven't been too many wide open shots.
Hubert Davis for three.
He can nail it.
Boy, they find a way to get him down when they count. It's 58-54, 3:05 to go.
Dean is usually a magician in the end of a game. How many games in his career he has pulled out?
And he has three timeouts to work with. Thomas Hill has been the star of this game, dogged by Fox.
They're not looking to completely stall. They're looking for the high percentage shot. There it is.
McCaffrey got it.
Created again with the double team and the great vision of Hill to throw the ball over the top of the defense.
McCaffrey has 7. The lead is 6.
That skip pass is so effective.
Throw it away.
Big possession.
Well, they'll milk the clock this time as much as they can.
Big possession. Oh, he bodied up on him. He's got to blow the whistle there.
King Rice gets only his first foul. Both teams are past 10 team fouls, so every common foul from now on is 2 shots.
I mentioned a little bit earlier in the game that I thought King Rice was one of the most maligned players in college basketball. What I mean by that, I want to be very clear. I really feel the kid has been productive in his career. You just have to look at his numbers. But because of the great expectation,
exactly,
where he was brilliant in the McDonald's game, many people, including yours truly, we talked about him possibly, and we're as guilty, I know I am. You talk about him being a next Phil Ford, and he comes in with that kind of reputation. Very difficult to live up to it.
It has not been vintage Bobby Hurley tonight. You saw his stats a moment ago, 8 assists, 8 turnovers, only his 3rd point.
But there's something about his game. Even when he makes mistakes, you don't mind him being on the floor because he's going to find some way to make the good play, and he plays so hard.
The lead is back to 8. North Carolina needs 3s.
Fox and Davis would be their 3-point shooters. Chilcutt as well.
Chilcutt will try it, spun out on him. And a foul underneath. And Thomas Hill and Lynch exchange tosses in the basketball.
Foul.
And a technical foul is called on Lynch.
Not a smart play at all by Lynch. Tough time to get a technical with 2 minutes. Dean will get him out of the game.
Dean Smith comes out, tells his team to sit down. They were up really protesting it. Bill Guthridge is saying, wait a minute, this was started by Duke. And he's right, because Hill threw the ball first at Lynch.
We're way up high, so it's so difficult. Now there's the contact. Oh, there's the ball being thrown.
Hill, that didn't show it, but Hill got in the first shot.
A good basketball team controls their emotions at the end of the game. Whether it be football, basketball, you have to play in a situation where you have poise. Duke did have the basketball, Mike, but now they get 2 opportunities plus the basketball.
2:13 left, an 8-point lead. And Thomas Hill will go to the line. They called the
They're
foul
still going
on the
at
box.
It.
Yes, they are.
They got to get them away from each other.
A lot of guys talking to each other.
I'd simply walk in. If I was blowing a whistle right now, I'd love to rep. I'd say, look, you guys, I'm going to tell you one quick one. I mean, to hit you with a tee so quick, you're not going to believe it.
Hill was fouled by Fox, his fourth, give him 16 points. The lead is up to 9. If you referee games, they go 4 hours.
Hey, maybe Freddie Barracata called me up. He does the greatest job in terms of evaluating his officials as the head of the officials in the ACC.
Hill has hit 5 of 6 from the line. Now 5 of 7, the lead 9 points. And now McCaffrey will shoot the technical.
It's 2 shots.
And why not? He's only a 90% free throw shooter.
He gets 2 attempts. I remember when I was coaching, Mike, an official sets the tone. If he lets you know quickly, I'm not going to tolerate it, you know you back off.
Of course, there is such an intensity between these teams and these players. They go after each other all the time. 65-54, and to make it worse, it's Duke's ball.
Yeah, they get possession of the ball. You know, the intensity starts before the game ever starts. It starts in a parking lot. It starts in the warm-ups with the crowd.
Laettner chased by Sullivan. They go to the double team.
He'll bring it back out. He'll spread the court.
They just want the clock to run here. Thomas Hill goes for the bucket and makes it.
He doesn't want the clock to run. He feels a 20-point night.
He has 18 points tonight. The lead at 13. Fox for 3.
Oh, what a game he has played. Kubek. Thomas Hill, though, sees the BMOC, big man on campus.
Hurley fouled by Hubert Davis with a minute 40 to go.
Bob Hurley cheering on with the crowd. The crowd loves it. The camera crazies erupt, baby.
And if this score stands, Duke would be 4-1 in the ACC. North Carolina would be 2-1. That's what they are right now. Duke would go to 4-1. North Carolina would drop to 2-1. And North Carolina State would be in a three-way tie and a loss come.
They're going to make that game up on February 7th with North Carolina State. Play back-to-back against each other. I'll tell you what, who do you think that favors?
Well, North Carolina State, you know, with five, six guys who can play, makes it very difficult for them.
They better win that first game before they go to Chapel Hill for game 2 because they're playing back-to-back.
Hurley with a missed free throw. He's 4 out of 5 from the line. Missed again. 13-point lead, 1:37 to go.
Don't want to foul.
Hubert Davis for 3. And North Carolina will spend a timeout as they've cut the lead to 10. We have seen this so many times before. Carolina, apparently done, has come back, so hang on.
Basically, trucks are used for 2 reasons, hauling and towing. And for that, you need power. And the Sierra from GMC truck has the most standard horsepower in its class, which gives you the hauling and towing strength you need. Plus, for 6 straight years, the full-size pickup from GMC Truck has retained more of its original value than any other in America. Sierra, powerful and durable. GMC Truck, it's not just a truck anymore. It's quality on the road.
This is not what you want in a shave. Now, you've got the edge. This is the shave with 6 rich lubricants. This is the shave that reduces irritation. This is the shave. For less irritation, you've got the edge.
1 minute, 31 seconds to play in Durham, North Carolina. It is Duke by 10.
So many times we hear the term, as we look at the timeout situation, fouls to give. You can see that on the screen. But we talk so much about defense, and it was epitomized here tonight. Duke was struggling, shooting 27% in the first half for most of it. But they kept digging in defensively, and they hung and they hung and they hung until they put together a run by Hill.
Well, it sounds like a cliche, but it's true. Coaches tell you defense is something you can play every night.
Oscar Robertson used to say that in Jerry West when the two guys played. And so we may have bad nights shooting the ball, but we're going to guard people as well.
And those guys didn't have too many bad nights either. Inbounds to Hurley. They try to draw the foul, and Hubert Davis will get the block instead. His third. Keep you up to date on some other scores. Syracuse has won, as has St. John's by two at home against Pitt.
Malik Sealy, what a year he is having. Hey, you know, you mentioned West, you mentioned Robertson. Tell MC Hammer to move over. I'm coming into the screen now, and I'm going to do a video. And I got my all Rolls Royce team. I want you to try and pick it one day. I'm not going to let you pick it tonight. The 50s, the 60s, the 70s, and the 80s. And then ultimately, my solid gold all Rolls Royce team.
Hurley hits the free throw. It's 68-57. Duke now by 11 with a minute 30 left.
It was a lot of fun to do, Mike. It really was. I had so much fun doing it.
69-57.
Get the bus, Dean. There's no way you're pulling magic getting this one out. Load the bus. Head to Chapel Hill. This baby belongs to the Blue Devils.
Hubert Davis misses the three. The rebound to Laettner, and he's fouled and comes up limping.
Chapel Hill is just the Taj Mahal when you go in that place in terms of blue heaven, the beautiful seats, the color scheme. But there's something special about a smaller environment. I would love to see in the Chapel Hill, let those students get a little closer to the sideline.
Laettner with 16 points.
He just keeps getting better and better as a player. He's becoming more and more a complete player, very confident. Next year he gets some size to help him with their recruits coming in. Cherokee Parks will be an instant player. 6'11 from California.
The lead is 14. North Carolina won both games last year, so it's payback time. Rice against Hurley. Rick Fox with a runner.
Nice cut by Fox without the basketball.
And North Carolina will use a timeout. Coming up later tonight, Brigham Young against Wyoming. That's a midnight start. Wayne Hagan and Terry Holland will be along to bring you that ball game.
Basically, the timeout right now, as you look at, you mentioned Terry Holland, as you said, so great to have Terry join us. A class act. Wyoming's been a real surprise team. They lost a tough one to Utah. But, you know, in the last 2 minutes, I'd like to see the NBA rule where the clock stops to eliminate the calling of timeouts by the coaches when they're down just to stop the clock.
Down to scoring for you. Thomas Hill, the leader with 18. Laettner has 17 for Duke. For North Carolina, Chilcutt was the leading scorer for a long time. He has 14, but Fox has taken over the lead with 17. Hubert Davis has 10.
Krzyzewskiville really had a party tonight. They've been partying for 2 weeks getting ready for this game. The tents outside, the pizza. How do they study? That's what I want to know. How do they study out there?
Well, here they got to find a way, I'll tell you that.
Look at the field goal percentages. That playing defense, they held North Carolina 32%. They shot 54%.
Laettner double teamed as we hit the 1 minute mark.
Oh, what a pass that was. Wide open. There's the
it off his knee out of bounds.
It's only fitting that Hill gets that dunk at the end.
Isn't it? Thomas Hill has 20 points, a brilliant effort tonight. Laettner double teamed and he's fouled.
What a pass Laettner threw over the double team from down on a baseline. Taking advantage of his great size, his mobility. What a tremendous pass that was over the trap.
Bob Hurley finds a way to win. You look at his stats tomorrow, you'll say, he didn't play a good game. But he made some big plays, and he did a heck of a job defensively.
47 seconds to go. And Duke will have won, undoubtedly, its biggest game of the year so far.
I'll tell you, there's something special about the Big Ten and the ACC, the Big East, the Southeastern Conference. Those games are absolutely, when you get into the league, so special, the environment, the intensity.
Duke has not shot the ball well from the free throw line as a team tonight, which is very surprising. And Laettner has been way off, 3 out of 6.
That only counts in baseball. You hit 3 out of 6, you're in the Hall of Fame.
Doing fine there, not here.
Too many people hit. Nobody's hitting 3 out of 6 in baseball. Take him out. He gets a standing O.
74-59, 18 points for Christian Laettner and a dozen rebounds. 3-point shot won't go. Tipped out of bounds. And Lenny Wirtz has a foul underneath. He was pointing at Crawford Palmer.
Mike Krzyzewski had them practice immediately after that blowout with Virginia, and he got them to regroup. This guy can teach, boy. You come and watch his team's practice. It's unreal the way he organizes every practice session. He's such a detailed man. Breaks everything down like a science.
Fox has hit 7 out of 7 from the line, has 17 points.
And you don't have to say that other guy can coach, because all you have to do is look at the numbers and see why he's in the Hall of Fame, where he belongs, and where King Bobby
Rice,
Knight.
King Rice is being booed as he leaves, and Sullivan will check back in. You were saying about Bobby Knight, certainly he belongs in it too.
Oh, he belongs in the Hall of Fame without a doubt. I'd like to see him put Al McGuire in the Hall of Fame as well for what he has done for college basketball, both as a coach and certainly as an announcer.
And because you beat him once.
I beat him once, only once. That's because I couldn't get the timeout to set up the play. That would have screwed up the whole game.
Fox misses the second shot, but Reese with the offensive rebound. Sullivan kicks it back out. They'll try the three. 30 seconds left, a 14-point game. Hurley will bring it back outside. He wants somebody to foul him, putting on a little dribbling exhibition. McCaffrey almost
all over. Hurley says, I got the rock. It's all over. That's his roommate. He and McCaffrey are roommates. You ought to credit this crowd, too. This crowd played a big part in this W. The formula was very simple tonight, Mike. Defense plus defense equals W.
Several players met and shook hands, but King Rice and Bobby Hurley were not two of them. Duke wins a very big game, goes to 4-1 in the ACC, 15-3 overall. North Carolina falls to 14-2, 2-1 overall. The final 74-60 from Durham for Dick Vitale and our entire ESPN crew. This is Mike Patrick. Thanks for watching, everybody. Let's go to John Saunders.
Thanks a lot, Mike and Dick. Some revenge for the Blue Devils, who last year lost both meetings against the Tar Heels. It ends an 11-game winning streak for North Carolina, and that's now 5 in a row for Duke. We want to remind you that following SportsCenter at 11:30 Eastern Time, we'll come back at midnight with our third and final game here. Sean Bradley, the 7'6 freshman for the Cougars of BYU. They'll face Wyoming in the Western Athletic Conference. That one comes your way at midnight Eastern Time. So we'll be back then. As for now, thanks for enjoying the ACC game here on ESPN's NCAA Basketball. ESPN's presentation of NCAA Basketball, North Carolina versus Duke, is brought to you by EDS, the world's most experienced computing and communications services company. Take advantage of change with EDS. By GMC Truck, it's not just a truck anymore. And by Edge Shaving Gel, for less irritation, you've got the edge.